Hi guys, Dr. M here, continuing the series of addition reactions across the alkenes. In this video, we're going to discuss epoxidation, which is formation of an epoxy, which is a small cyclic three-membered ether of general structure like that. So that's an epoxide. It's an ether in itself. It's a cyclic ether. It's the smallest cyclic ether. All right. So we always use MCPBA, whose structure is like is this. This is the structure of MCPBA right here. And in full, it's meta chloroperoxybenzoic acid. So MCPBA. All right. So that just simply puts an epoxide, puts an oxygen across the double bond and using one of the pi bonds. It's going to be syn addition. That's the regioselectivity. Same side addition. The oxygen is added on either the top face, or bottom face. You know the planarity here is what causes racemic mixtures from the reactions, because if this area is planar, then that means you could either do the reaction from the top face or bottom face, and the pre-existing groups would be either be flushed up or down from the opposite side where the addition took place. And you lose the unsaturation. That means you lose the double bond to get a single bond. Okay. So again, you get an epoxide plus it's an enantiomer. And this is going to be the byproduct. The metachlorobenzoic acid will be the byproduct. For the mechanism, looks strange, but MCPBA, which is this structure, reacting with the alkene in this structure, is going to be attacked by the pi bond on its oxygen. So the oxygen in blue is going to be attacked by the pi bond, and the oxygen in blue is going to use its lone pair in turn to attack the other carbon, where the arrow in blue is going to form a bond to the oxygen and the lone pair is going to form another bond to this carbon. If it happens from the top face, this is the structure you get. The ethylene metal will be flushed back. If it happens from the bottom face, like down there, again, the oxygen is going to be at the bottom and the ethylene metal will be flushed up, and you get chlorobenzoic acid as a byproduct. Okay, the Cl they are missing. So let's look at examples. Worked examples. Fill in the missing reaction products showing stereochemistry. Where possible, use wedges or hatch bonds. If possible, indicate major minor product, and I would say also say if it's racemic mixture or enantiomers and diastereomers formed. Okay, now in this case, MCPBA, again, you're trying to form an epoxide and it's going to be syn addition, and the reaction is formation of epoxide, so it's epoxidation. And since it's syn addition, so from this side, if you're adding your epoxide from the top face using blue, this is the product you would expect to have. So you did your addition from the top face, you need to use the wedges. Okay? And the pre-existing ethyl metal will be flushed back. So you use dash bonds. So let's assume the same thing happened on this side. So the epoxide added on the top face, the epoxide was added from the top face, that's what you get. What if you do the opposite? In which case, we are adding from the bottom face, that means your epoxide will have a dashed bond. Epoxide will have a dashed bond, okay? And your ethyl and methyl will be flushed to the top side because the reaction happened from the bottom face. You do realize right now that you have other possible structures, which are these ones. So these are the other two products, and they're gonna be enantiomers, between themselves. Okay, so these are enantiomers. But if you are to compare these two, they're going to be diastereomers. If you've not learned that topic yet, just find the topic which talks about RNS configurations. I'm going to explain how you get isomers based on stereochemistry. Anyway, for now, just know you're getting four different structures depending on how the epoxide attacked the molecule, right? Of course, the byproduct is metachlorobenzoic acid. Next question. So we're going to do the same here with epoxidation. It says two equivalents, so I'm gonna assume we added on both sides. It's in addition, and because the molecule is completely symmetrical, there's no need of drawing the enantiomer of this, because it's gonna be either or. Instead, I'm just going to do bottom face addition to your left and top face addition to your right to avoid repetitions. Next question here, you're going to get two possible structures where you're adding your epoxide from the top face, okay, or you're adding it from the bottom face. So those two are enantiomers, racemic mixtures, 50%, 50% equal chance of formation. That's why it's called a racemic mixtures. And their relationship, the enantiomers, because they are just complete opposite stereochemistry. Okay, for this one, adding the epoxide from the bottom to get this structure, flushing the pre-existing hydrogens on the top, or you adding the epoxide from the top, so you give it a wedge, adding pushing the hydrogens away. In this case, it's either or. So either this answer or this one. Why either or? Because again, these two molecules have an internal plane of symmetry. See, you have an internal plane of symmetry, so it can't be both of them. Okay, so that's it about syn epoxidation, forming a cyclic ether. It's in addition, same phase addition with possible racemic mixtures. All right, thank you. See you soon for the next video about reactions on epoxide opening. Bye.